Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here from LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Back with another free agent signing. This time, it's former Golden State Warrior Juan Toscano-Anderson signing with a veteran minimum deal for your Los Angeles Lakers. Joining me to discuss is Sean Davis from LakersNation.com. Sean, JTA, coming to the Lakers. What do you think?
Solid, you know, signing to fill some of the end of your roster. A good defender who has a lot of great instincts and guarded some of the best players in the world. Guarded Damian Lillard, like legit guarded him for a few possessions in a row, holding his own, forcing some tough shots and some misses there. And he was just really reliable and somebody that Golden State could count on, but kind of fell out of the rotation due to Kuminga playing well and them trying to get the young guys involved. Also, Otto Porter Jr. just being a better player. So they're prioritizing him and some of the younger guys that they had over in Golden State. But whenever they needed JTA, just a reliable guy that can defend, a smart basketball player. And I think this is a good, valuable contract for the veteran minimum.
Now, a little bit older than some of the other players we've seen. The Lakers have been targeting youth. We've got Troy Brown, Lonnie Walker, 29 years old, Juan Toscano-Anderson. Doesn't feel like he should be because he's only been in the league for 3 years, but made the leap to the NBA later than most at age 26. Averaging 36% from three for his career. A solid, dependable guy on the defensive end of the floor. 6'6". Look, we said going in that the Lakers need wings. And yes, we talked about guys like TJ Warren, Otto Porter Jr., players like that. But it appears the Lakers are kind of going the volume approach, saying, look, if we can't get the top tier guys, if these guys are going to be out of our price range, let's get guys who are young enough where they've got some bounce in their legs, and let's get guys who we think can battle for spots in our rotation and potentially be factors there. I don't mind it, especially when we look and see what the Lakers did last season, where they found success. Guys like Stanley Johnson, guys like Wenyen Gabriel, Austin Reeves, these guys who hadn't really been expected to be part of a rotation anywhere. The Lakers found ways to turn them into some pieces that could help them out. And I think with the wings that they brought in, we could be seeing the same thing. And Juan Toscano-Anderson has that championship experience now. I think at 29, he's the kind of presence that you're going to need on this team on the wing to be that dependable guy. Only averaged 13 minutes per game for the Warriors, but still on this Lakers team, I feel like he's a nice depth addition, particularly given how badly this team needs wings.
Agreed. Again, if you're asking him to play 12 to like 16, 17 minutes a game, that's fine. Again, just a dependable defender that is a capable three-point shooter. But I'm curious to see. That's something I'm kind of a little surprised so far that they haven't went shooter, like strictly shooter. A little surprised so far, but I do think that's coming. But a good signing with Juan Toscano-Anderson, Sean. Good defender, and I'm excited to see what the Lakers do with the rest of the free agency.
Are you worried a little bit at skill set duplication between Lonnie Walker, Juan Toscano-Anderson, Troy Brown? Now you got Stanley Johnson. When you get, you know, you add in all these guys, is there too much overlap there, or do you see enough differentiation between those guys to where the Lakers can kind of, Darvin Ham can kind of deploy them as needed?
I think I can see where you think it would be skill set duplication, but in this case, I think it's a good thing. The Lakers need guys that can defend. You are a little bit worried about the shooting, but if Stanley's really been in the gym working on the shot, then that's a massive upgrade for you. Lonnie Walker is a capable three-point shooter, probably closer to 35% than he was last year at 30, just under 32%. So I understand that, but this is a good thing to have skill duplication with guys that can defend and are okay three-point shooters. I do expect we're going to see a guy that's just a strict shooter at some point, whether it's tonight or in the coming days.
Most likely, you know, we've been saying if you're going to gamble on some of these guys, get the guy who can defend first and then just at least keep defenses honest from three. That should be the preference here, and it feels like that's the way the Lakers have gone. Also of note that we're seeing a lot of Clutch Sports clients. Maybe not a surprise, but maybe a precursor. Yeah, that's a lot on the Lakers roster, but maybe a sign of things to come. Like, I'm not saying this means LeBron's going to sign that extension, but it doesn't hurt that the Lakers are clearly still very, very involved with Clutch Sports. There's no divorce looming there, obviously, with the Lakers' decisions here in free agency as well as in the draft.
Yeah, agreed. I just think it's eight, if you count Scottie Pippen Jr. There's eight guys that are affiliated with Clutch on the Lakers roster. I think that's hilarious.
All right. Well, in any event, Juan Toscano-Anderson, quality addition, quality guy that you can bring in there and provide a little bit of depth on the wing, which is exactly what the Lakers need. Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.